which are labeled differently on Start GG, but if you're just looking at it from top to bottom, this is going to be number 5. And in here is going to be Honeybee. Going up against Perfect Shinny here.
It's actually nice to see Perfect Shinny offline.
Yeah.
I recall seeing, and I even think I've commentated some Perfect Shinny online in the past. And now, you know, as we are in Combo Breaker, things are offline again and people are grinding. Honeybee, a bit of an unusual weekend for him, as currently, at this moment in time, his brother Biohazard is not competing in tournaments.
He's focusing on real life. He's retired. That's what I've been told. Just retired. He's done. And big chilling at home. Just focusing on life.
Focusing on real life, man. And, you know, Biohazard had one hell of a run here. Honeybee is still going. Which means that, you know, when the... It was in jest, but, you know, I said to Honeybee earlier, he came up and said hi, and I was like, how's the trip been now? You've sort of been traveling solo. He had a smile on his face. He looked at me and he went, lonely.
Oh, and I was no. Like,
as someone where, like, you know, I'm traveling to Evo without Mustard this year, I'm going to feel the exact same way.
Wow.
But still rocking it, the number one Devora player in the world, and it's not even close.
Yeah.
Let's see if it's enough.
Still a threat in every single online North American tournament that's happened in the last year. Honeybee grinding every single day. He's a streamer, content creator, and one of the best competitors we have to offer. Here, representing Canada. And Perfect Shinigami. I think it's short for Perfect Shinigami. I always want to say that. But Perfect Shinny here, one of the first times offline, if I'm not mistaken. We'll have to ask him later. Look at that.
Woo! That worked?
Mom?
I think I'm going to be sick, Miss Ackerman.
Dad? Is that allowed? Was that illegal? Was that an illegal move in MK11?
Can we call the judge?
Judge ruled it was okay. We're good. He'll allow it. Get back to the corner with you. Ooh, the bug didn't come out in time, and on amplification, it ain't going nowhere. Perfect Shinigami's been perfectly active in this matchup.
Sorry, I got jump scared by that fatal blow. Sorry, I watched John Carpenter's The Thing the other day, and it just gave me horrible, horrible flashback.
Oh my god. But it was gonna be safe on block because of the amplified bugs.
That's why I did it.
That's why I did it, guys.
Risk-free. Oh, you're tricked. You want to punish that teleport, mate? Sorry, Maya.
What is it? Your
my mate's behind me, man. He really wants to meet you. Boom, boom, boom.
Honeybee does a good job of not giving you a turn. What a challenge.
Now, there's one thing Cetrion's not going to do outside of KBs, and that's really do damage. So a lot of these plays not going to be so risky. Honeybee won't be as afraid to take those risks.
That's if there's any weakness to Mama Cetrion, it's the fact that she's going to tickle you on her hits.
Unless you get to KB, then whatever.
Ooh, yeah, don't gonna hurt. Is it fatal? Honeybee getting aggressive. He's one of the most aggressive players in this scene. Known to always have that gas pedal to the metal, all the way to the floor.
There is no off switch with Honeybee's Devora. There never has been and there never will be. Letting it go. Oh, that was an answer and a half. What a choice.
That was going to be Honeybee's turn for quite some time, I feel like, if he would have blocked that. Wow.
Clean anti-air and going in with the immediate tornado just in case you try and break that. Not quite close enough to get the down forward.
Yeah, that would have been amazing. That would have been amazing. I've never seen that from a Devora player. But if there's something that I've said about Honeybee's Devora, it's I've never seen that before until Honeybee did it. Just like the flashback in the day, when he has his heart set on a character, he pushes that character to some limits that no one else can.
There has been a rather constant use of challenging. Oh, tries to get the standing one, but I mean, a bit of an awkward combo to complete right there.
You almost never see the sweep setup work, but he was about to combo after a sweep.
Perfect Shinny doing a fantastic job, not only of fighting out of the corner, but just giving himself some ground to work with. Fatal blow still available for Cetrion. Honeybee using his in round one, so gone for some time, plus frame. The respect. Down four, though. Oh, no! That's going to set up to something. Wonderful!
Wait!
What a block!
Under break tornado, and that's going to be it! Perfectly timed for Perfect Shinny on the armor break tornado, shutting that down. And what a sequence. You talked about it. Where's the damage going to come from? The KBs. All Honeybee had to do was something that wasn't punishable.
but he wanted to enforce the mix-up. You know, that came down to an overhead or low or a grab, something where normally it's a risk-reward, not really in your favor, but at that health, had to do it. And Perfect Shinny made the perfect decision, and now full combo here for Honeybee.
It's in the name, like Mr. Perfect back in the 90s, and then, not to make another wrestling reference on here, and he gets shimmied by one of the best shimmy tools. 4-2 of Devorah's has clipped more people than I think any other shimmy I've seen in the past year.
I'm liking that development. Bug into down forward to puddle. That's something I haven't seen much. Oh. Firm, all right, wait a minute. Saying a perfect shinny. Yo, dude, why are you pressing buttons here? Hey, the bugs. My children, they follow me.
Oh. And she's got a billion of them.
She does.
Round two.
How is anyone beating her in Outworld? She has an army.
Go, well, you know. Anyone ever watched the live-action Mortal Kombat Conquest? Kriya didn't win. Sorry, spoilers. Came out like 20 years ago. If you haven't seen it yet, it's going to fall. Whee! There you go, jump in. 2-1, knockdown for the bugs to come through.
And the abusive jump one range of Devorah. You can anti her. You can challenge it if you time it perfectly. And Shetron Stand 1 can do a good job, but so can the rock wall. But it's bold, because then once you start to show Honeybee that card, he's got a change point. Whoa!
Oh my lord, I mean, clearly the actor frames just caught her on the way down, but it still looked hilarious to me. Oh, that was a big risk, that one. That was a big risk. At least though, Honeybee, that KB is no longer active. You know, I guess silver linings and all that, but the combo extension, Shinny doing a fantastic job, 30%, whee, and finishes the job. Perfect Shinny.
My patience runs out.
I actually do believe the scores are wrong, aren't they?
Final round.
Honeybee's not 1-0, it's Perfect Shinny.
Perfect Shinny 1-0?
Yeah.
I'm like 4% sure.
I'm fairly certain Perfect Shinny won that first game. No, because it blocked the overhead.
Oh, you're right. Oh wait, Cowboy, there's a puddle again, and what? He had to block all of that. For 20 seconds? Beautiful setup from Honeybee. Get spaghetti air. Put his input in too early. What's Honeybee for the conversion? The bug not gonna save him. You can challenge those non-amplified bugs that she puts on the ground, guys. As long as you can force a block or get a hit, they're gonna be out of here. The amplified one, no fly zone.
Speaking of which, a little bit too far away for all of them to connect. However, that is going to be Honeybee taking a game, and now we are tied up.
1-1. Honeybee looking calm, cool, collected, composed. I can't think of any other words. Same thing with Perfect, though.
Chilling.
Unfazed. Fight. By the pressure. And I saw some players come off stage earlier, hands shaking, trembling from the pressure that being on stage and performing here can do to a person. You've been there.
Hey, yes, I have.
I've been there, too, on the receiving end of a down two crushing blow.
Sorry, I was reacting to the down two. I wasn't just really enthusiastic to answer your question. Dab, right? Calm down, I only asked you.
Hey, my bad.
All right, another confirm here, Perfect Shinny. Once again, not damaged, but set up in a situation. Another neutral duck, Honeybee. Making the hard read, but they're working wonderful so far.
He's one of those, he reminds me a little bit of, you know, there's not a lot of players like Honeybee left. I was gonna say a little bit like myself, but those high risk, high reward kind of reads, he lives or dies by the sword. That's always been Honeybee since the beginning, but it leads to some of the most electrifying gameplay that's existed in our community.
Going in for regular tornado. I like that Shinny chose to back up. Oh, you're done.
He doesn't need to come off a fatal blow. Puddle down two.
I was going to say, I actually do like the fact, though, that in that situation, Shinny did the regular tornado and then chose to back up, because regular tornado is like plus two. It's like, you basically not plus. You have to amplify it to get some kind of situation for free. And, all right.
That was gross.
It is every time Honeybee does it. Lovely hit confirm. How about, I mean, is it even going to be worth breaking here? I guess we'll find out. Again, 2-2. I think Honeybee's had a bit of a hard time getting that puddle.
Mm-hmm. And no resources right there. And it's perfect recognition from Shinny to see that and take his turn even here. Can swing if he wants to. Thought Honeybee was going to press first. Oh, that's a nice boulder. That showed up. He's got the tech. No punish there. And how many times? Is it just gonna work? Perfect Shinny, I think, has got the hit. Oh no, now he's getting eaten alive. Those amplified bugs are destroying him. You know, you have to weather the storm. Yeah, he could throw some mix-ups, but he's getting hit by, you know, the raw teleports after maybe being a little too impatient against them. Because Honeybee's just going in.
Here's the thing. Perfect Shinny is currently being coached. Historically, how can you really coach against Honeybee, though? Because he has such a unique style. Unless you've played Honeybee.
Yeah.
I actually do question how useful that information would even be. Not to sound disrespectful, it's just that when you fight with it, you're against someone that has such a unique style. I do wonder what you can even say to answer back, apart from maybe some obvious stuff.
You're just thinking about it.
Oh, is that's
it,
so sick.
What in the world? Is it being more patient on the amplified bugs? Is it challenging these neutral jump ones from a distance? You know, because I know, everyone knows, that has studied Honeybee's play, that was godlike. There's an answer. But he knows, and there's the early stand one, is that you know that Honeybee's going to be abusing the jump one, and he's going to be abusing those bugs. Good zoning, and the active frames have been helping them on those Hellzraths. This is Bug's biggest weakness.
Hang on a minute. A little bit more of it in there. The chip damage.
Oh no.
Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. But again, a little bit hit and miss with that.
So yeah, he did. I think he didn't know what to do right there.
I feel like he's trying to puddle. I mean, I could be getting it wrong, but it looks like he's trying to puddle, and that's why he's getting a little duck. But I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking too much into it. We're actually seeing it. Oh, could have been a full life comeback, but the natural barrier said no.
And that's the first time that he just did it, knowing that Honeybee was going to neutral jump at that range. And from that range, he might be able to. He's the block. No, even better. He's got the teleport. He teleported through the teleport. And gets the punish.
Devorah literally just went up and then straight back down again.
Hello there.
Not getting caught by these mids so much. It was a real problem beforehand. Dagger game.
4-2 ate him up in the last game alone. Even there, hard to read because now we're probably going to start to see some more throws from Honeybee. Maybe some stand one throws. Jumping throws. Exactly. Because that's how you get someone to fall for that 4-2. Vignette!
Lovely anti-air. Did not see that much before.
Leave the restand.
Perhaps that anti-air was what the coaching was about, I wonder. Either way, side switching throw, not scouted out there by Perfect Shinny. Like, what are you going to do?
And really good, what I say, waiting it out and oh, may have tried an anti-air there too and got clipped. But I like the presence of mind to wait out the bugs, just look for the simple mix-ups. The worst you're gonna eat is like a quick overhead or a quick low, you know, a sweep or a back two or a throw. None of them are gonna kill you right there. But if you don't block, those bugs in a full combo will. Whoa, and still.
Well worth the trade. Well worth the trade, Mr. Ackerman.
Is it though? 14 for 282 and more bugs?
Yeah, I'm talking about a trade for Honeybee.
Oh, absolutely.
Of course it's not a good trade for Perfect Shitty. I'm not stupid.
Man, died today. Oh, there's a big counter.
Counter hit. Quite rightly so. Spending extra bar to get that 39%. Yeah, with the crushing blows, the damage is nowhere near as lacking, shall we say. But this will be a match point for Honeybee. A little bit more work, and he'll be able to move on here versus Perfect Shinny, doing really well so far. This grab is good, but now you got to watch out for Fatal Blow.
Bugs are out. Time to play. If only he would have just won one Fatal right there. Doesn't break the armor because only the first hit does. Resets neutral. Put out the wall of active frames.
Really any smart projectile will do it here, and he knows it. Ship damage, the big neutral jump. Doesn't want to risk challenging it and put himself minus enough that even if there was a low poke there, he did not have the last breath. He was just a frame or so shy of
three
that defensive bar.
Matches. I think all three matches for top 32 in a row now. Going to a game number 5. Combo breaker, ladies and gentlemen. And I think that the adjustment for Perfect Shinny was more patience. That's one thing I saw in that last game, was just much more patience against the storm, the proverbial storm that's Devorah's pressure, and the swarm that comes out of her.
Not a surprise, natural barrier still hit from that range. I wonder if maybe Honeybee pressed a button or something. Either way, Perfect Shinny with another little conversion. Down to the challenge.
There it is! If you're early enough, if you're confident enough, it can't exist. Again! Shut that down, it's not gonna be a full cover. Whoa! Some old school buttons there. An offensive bar, that's gonna be the round and perfect. Shinny is now on match point with the spin to win.
I kinda wonder if that's what the coaching could have been. You know you can anti-air that jump one, right? Hurt box gets extended. It may look dangerous, but you can anti-air it. There it is!
And I know we don't talk about it, but Cetrion stand one is one of the best anti-airs in MK11.
Yeah, what doesn't this character have? Perfect Shinny's doing a great job of adapting to this matchup so far, and a confirm Honeybee's now in big trouble! And it just continues. The late down two.
And we saw the impatient down two in the last round. He is shutting this down completely. Honeybee getting run over by the wreath of Perfect Shinny, the anti-airs. Honeybee, when he's gotten shut down, looks a little lost.
I think he's been overwhelmed in this round, and quite rightly so.
What
Perfect
an
Shinny
adjustment.
Takes it over Honeybee.
It took a little while. It took eating a couple of jump ones to the face, yes. But after a while, once a couple of those stand ones connected, once a couple of those, you know, decisions to, again, wait out the amplified bug and then make a read, both of those things, to me, immediately put him back in this match. And by the end, the adjustments were fully made, and we saw him fully on display, where Honeybee couldn't even jump with Devorah. Name anyone that's ever been able to say, oh yeah, I stopped Honeybee from jumping completely. I don't think anyone can raise their hand.
It was a night and day.
Other than Perfect Shinny right now.
Like, when it comes to adaptation, it was a night and day difference of the moment I can start challenging these jump-ins and stopping you from essentially doing what you want to do, which is what Honeybee's known for, you know. Extremely overwhelming and setup heavy and all that good stuff, but can change dramatically if you know your specific options. And I guess Cetrion standing one is such an amazing anti-air that those options are pretty plentiful.
Just another wonderful match for us catch-up. Are they going to keep throwing them at us? Are we just going to keep getting game fives? This is, hey, no pun intended, but this is a wet dream for me.
Hey, man, it's... But all I'm saying is, I'm just going to pretend I didn't hear that. I'm not sure how many games we have left of this commentary block, but we've just been blessed with fantastic match after
fantastic match. I'm assuming one more in this block, because that was three for top 32 from this block. We usually do four on the winner's side. So, Perfect Shinny, I believe, is out in winner's top 32, guys. And Honeybee will have to play what's going to be most likely off stream. So if you guys are fans of Honeybee, you'll have to be following closely. What a turnaround. What could have been right here for Honeybee, put himself on match point here, and Shinny, just the adjustments clicked. We've already spoken about it, and now we get to watch it back.
It was that final round for Honeybee, just preemptively trying to do a bunch of stuff. Just didn't work out, getting clipped all over the place. It was unfortunate. You know, that final round, everything that could have gone wrong went wrong, and that happens to everyone. Perfect Shinny, happy to capitalize on that and playing fantastic. Enough so to make it out in winners, which is a great achievement. Getting top 32 in a tournament like this is no easy feat at all.
And there's a small chance that Cetrion makes it out in both sides of this bracket. Because on the other side, Woozy is still in this one. I don't know how the bracket looks right now. There's probably one more match for top 32 out of this. And I know that on that side, we haven't seen it a lot. Woozy's over there. K7 Showoff. Dialogue, a bunch of names I recognize. We're on that side of the bracket that I don't know how it unfolded off stream. So who is going to be playing for that top 32 spot?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing it, man. Looking forward to seeing it. Question is, though, who's going to be stepping up to the plate next? Because the more game fives that we're getting through, I mean, these players that are having to wait for their time to play on stream or whatever it is, they're sitting there and enjoying the show. But there's players like, man, I just want to play. I just really want to play. And you get eager for it. You get... There's a lot of anticipation there, I suppose. And then when it's finally time to sit down, you know, it's do or die, really, when you're playing on that stage. Very, very different beast. But, yeah, there's a lot of killers in this bracket. And even in this pool itself, we've seen some excellent games. It's hard to pick what the best one was because there's been so many.
Yeah, that was just incredible, guys. But we are actually going to stick to the schedule, and so we will be going to a break. But when we come back, there's only two pools left, and I'm going to give you guys a quick recap of some of the faces that you're going to see, some of the action to expect in these last couple of pools. Rewind.